Hey YouTubers, Xander here, welcome back to Stardew Valley. I was wrong about the price of gold bars, they're only 250, not 500. But yeah, made a lot of money. Focusing on money because we want to complete the vault bundle as soon as possible. And so close, but not enough. Cloudy with gust of wind tomorrow. Neutral. Now, apparently, the luck staff for that whole neutral thing isn't 100% accurate in that regard. What it actually means is that there is a 0.2 positive or negative effect on our luck. And the range is 1 in either direction, so positive 100, negative 100. So yeah, basically, we actually have a potential range of negative 0.2 to positive 0.2. There we go. Three hearts already, nice. Should be expecting a large egg soon then. Have I already turned one in? Nope, wrong one. Yes, I have, okay. Never mind then. Silly me. Allow pregnancy. There we go. Yay. Blackberries. More. I need to make 400 gold today. That's how I'm going to do it. Oh, well, that's convenient. Gosh, almost just because I want to. So we recover 2 health per enemy? Oh, there's a rock in the way. Huh. Oh, that's bad. Nice. Damn it. I was too busy looking at my health to actually watch for things that could lower it. Also, hello, bats. Why are there so many bats? Face the right way, damn it. Freaking hell. Die. Phew. That was intense. Here we go. Nice. Need those solar essences. Oh, I forgot about that. Okay. Oh, cool. First try. That's good. Damn it. See ya. I think we'll explore this floor and then head back up. Nice. Okay, it's explored. That was easy. Okay, so we can't actually enter the floor that we're on. That's good to know, I guess. Blackberry Bosh. Nom 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 nom. Actually, how close am I to the Void Spirits? Only 26 more. Wow, we actually got 1,800 extra, which is good. So with this we will... We're gonna not just complete the... I was too focused on completing the vault itself. Now what the reward for that bundle is... If I remember correctly, it's the Crystallarium. Oh, sweet Jesus. Yes! So the Crystallarium, one set... down, we put a gem in it, and depending on the house was empty for years. The trees moved in, and so did we. We'll put a gem in it, and depending on what the, like, quality of the gem is over time, after a certain number of days, it will just start, it'll produce those gems. And, yeah, so we plant a diamond in there, and we just start getting free diamonds every couple of days. There we go, 2 stars down. Next season we'll have another one down, I think. Yeah, we will. I should have grabbed those blackberries. Oh well. Too late to go back now. No turning back. Hmm. depending on their money situation, I might still... Right back where we were. Just throw that down, make it a little easier. Woo! So after 26 more void spirits, we'll actually gain a... Wow, another strange bun. Another type of ring. I can't remember what it does, though. I want to say it's a skeleton type of ring. I can't remember which I liked more, the vampire or the skeleton. Okay. Alright, cool. Omni-geode, I'll take it. Oh, cool. I was about to start digging for a way down. Hello. Solar essence? Let's get rid of you first. No, but iron ore, I guess, is fine. Copper. Fire quartz. I need to see what happens when you refine fire quartz. I still have yet to do that in either of my, any of my... Well, probably did in my original file, but that's so long ago, I've forgotten. Do we get refined quartz or refined fire quartz? Because if we just get refined quartz, then screw it, sell them. I don't need them. Come on. Hit the rock. Hey, cool. Another strange bun. Wow. Hello, Mr. Crab. Ah, that didn't reveal the exit. And then the very next rock I... Hello. Mine. Has the ladder. That's a lot of, like... Oh, Jesus. Oh, shoot. Yay, Ruby. Another strange bun. Wow. You might as well just call it here. Head back up. Take the detour. Scenic route. There we go. That's the term. Take the scenic route and... That's not what I meant. There we go. Collect blackberries. Check the beach again in hopes of a rainbow shell. Gosh, I wish I wouldn't have sold those. But then again, I didn't know back then that I would need one. I had forgotten. I really hope it's not a summer exclusive. I still need to look that up now that I think about it. I wouldn't imagine it being one, but you never know. Nothing here. Shoot. Hmm. Come on, pick it. Cool. We can start saving void essences again. Oops. Guess we'll keep the rest. Almost there. Head to bed. Yeah, boy. Who knew that forest creature thingies are mechanics? How much are these worth? 225 each. Wow. Heh, 220 each. No, 200 each? Yeah, 200 each, sorry. I mathed wrong, I apologize. Gonna be cloudy with gust of wind. Ouch. So that's bad. Oh, I never switched my, guess I'll just do this. No, I am out. Oh, of coal. I'll save the rest of the gold ore just because I think there is stuff that we can make with pure gold ore. Yams are done. Now we're just waiting on the pumpkins. Oh, and all these are done, duh. Oops. Oops. Oh my god, inventory's so full of various quality. Oh. Well, that's kind of a tease. I don't know if I can actually cut those down or not. I don't even feel like filling that up right now. I just milked the wow. Okay. Okay, real quick, we need to start working on getting 5 items saved up for the festival thing. So I'm just gonna kind of save all my like gold star stuff. And then when the time comes, I'll pick like 9 of them. I didn't fill my watering can. I'm so sorry. I don't care. Perfect timing. So we're gonna head to the new area of the map. To do that, we need to pay 500 gold. And welcome to the desert. And more specifically, cutscene oasis. A customer. Sandy's Oasis. Always like that face. You poor burnt thing. Alright, so this is what she has. She has the star fruit, which is interesting. But she also has rhubarb and specifically beets. And then I guess deluxe speed grow, but what we want is beets. And we're just going to grab like 30 of these. Because we need 10. For later. Now obviously a shop isn't all we can do. I think we can, we can chop down these palm trees. Okay, so yeah, that's a thing. You can pick all these. Can I? Okay, I was gonna say, I was like, can I cut down cacti? Well, sure. This is useful out for one point or another later. There's a fishing spot right here. We can actually catch a fish that's relevant to the bundle. I think it's specialty fish. Yeah, we can catch a sandfish here. But this is another thing. It's got a skull on it, a skull on it, and we have the skeleton key. And we have now unlocked we unlocked the other mine. And the name is escaping me right now for some reason. But this is an endless mine. There is no bottom. There is no elevator. It goes on forever. So your only limit is the time of day. Everything in here is also extremely difficult to fight. That's why when I saw that the first room was basically nothing but enemies, I was like, nope, can't do that. Okay. And these things will devastate you. So I do not want to show much. But the main reason to head here is the fact that, oh, there's also those bugs. Those are immortal bugs. You cannot kill them no matter what. Ouch. And there's also pitfalls that allow you to fall distances. We already got lucky by finding a diamond. But the deeper you go, the greater the chance of better loot. This is where we collect our iridium ore. Ouch. Another thing to be wary about is those giant slimes actually have a chance of splitting into three or four smaller ones that are just as strong as the original. So we must be careful. But those slimes also have a chance of dropping iridium ore, which is good, obviously. So this is where we'll... Once we get better stuff, this is where we'll be hanging out a lot, probably. But obviously, I really want a better weapon, as well as more bombs. And the specific reason for the bombs, I'm not even going to head down there because of that slime. The reasons for the bombs is, one, you can bomb your way down to get to the deeper levels faster. And also, the mummies that were shown in the first floor the second time we entered, they die, but then they come back over time, like re-deads in one of the Legend of Zelda games. Also, I can't believe I missed that. I need to go back for that after I find the stairs. And so, the only way to permanently kill them is with a bomb. I'm actually going to eat some blackberries, get my health and energy up, since I can't seem to find the ladder that I need. Well, that was pointless. One thing to also take note of is time. You have to really pay attention to here, because unless you have a teleportation item, you have to remember that once you exit the thing, you also need to take the bus back. See? A lot of health. Now imagine having to fight four of those at once. Not fun. Oh, shit. Oh, cool. Free bomb. Thank you. And another thing that people usually do with these is have staircases. Or lots of stone in order to build staircases. And the reason for that is so if you're having difficulty finding the ladder within the first few rocks, you can just build a staircase, drop down immediately, instead of doing what I'm currently doing. Unfortunately, I don't have enough stone on me to actually make a staircase. So basically, everything for these mines is all about conserving time. But the rewards that you get once you reach the couple hundreds of floors, if you can make it, are just hundreds of thousands of iridium. And that's a lie. It's hundreds of iridium, not thousands. Really? Where is my ladder on this? Alright, well, it's a... Okay. Alright, well... Damn it, unlucky, 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 unlucky. A little bit more lucky. Luckily we had them trapped, so we were able to kill them quite easily. And we got 2 iridium ore from it, as well as a couple other rewards. And that's one of the main positive things about those slimes, is that you can reap a lot of stuff if they do manage to spawn the stuff. Probably at about 9 p.m. is when we'll leave this mine. I wasn't planning on delving deep into it because I knew it would be too difficult with my current weapon. But then I just kind of started going and whatever. Let's actually set it right like there. And it found us the staircase. Okay, that we're not even going to like... Yeah. I didn't realize bats could actually spawn in here. Interesting. Nope. Fuck. Let me just not face the right direction in the slightest. Because, you know, reasons. The number of... Ooh, hello. Oh. Lame. The number of omni-geodes I am gathering, though, is very good. Also, hello, Frozen Tear. Don't mind if I do. Now, if we were actually working towards delving deep into the mines, we would not be exploring each floor like we're currently doing. We'd just be, like, find the ladder, go down, find the ladder, go down. There's stuff on the way of finding the ladder, then awesome. If not, oh well. Like, at this point, I'm just going to do this. And there we are. Okay, this is bad, this is bad. I can't really see them that well, just keep attacking! That's bad, okay, that's bad, that's bad, that's bad. Eat! Let me eat! Why is it when I'm against the wall I can't actually eat? It's so odd. Yeah, unfortunately one of them got really pissed and that was just like... Spelling disaster. Die, please. Thank you. Hello? Got some iridium ore and just a straight up iridium bar. That's really good. All right, I don't care about copper ore. So now we've kind of shown both aspects of the slime, when you get lucky and when not so lucky. Is that worth it? If I eat bunch of blackberries, it will be. Well, I guess I could be eating these. Woof. Oh well. Oh geez, there's a second one. I did not expect there to be 2. Okay, phew. I'm just gonna kinda walk past it. See ya. It's trapped anyways. He needs 2 block space to be able to make it past. Okay. I heard one of those flying things. Yeah, I don't know exactly what they are. They're like dragons-ish. Oh, cool, Bob. Yeah, we're gonna head on out now. Crud. I just remembered that. So, there's actually going to be a quest that we'll get tomorrow. That'll basically be like, hey, I see you found the mines. Go down to floor 25. What? And if you do, I'll give you a big prize. It actually is, spoilers, 10,000 gold. If we manage to make it down to level 5 after he gives us that quest. Okay, I think we want to keep the rest. We now have 2 iridium bars, and we can make a fifth, or third. What the hell? I said fifth just because I'm thinking about the fifth one. Because for something very useful towards going through that mine, those mines, requires 5 iridium bars. So I actually want to try and get that. Hell, I'll deposit those for now. Tomorrow we'll plant those and grow those just because, well, I mean, we do technically have the time. Oh, duh, I never donated the yam. Shoot, well, it's not that important. Oh, I also need that. 7 Omni Geodes, though. Not bad. Boom. Oh, I forgot the bait. Okay, so yeah, I know it is. I missed a spot. There, got it. That didn't go bad, actually. I'm quite pleased with what the results were. I need more bug meat. I don't even have bait. Huh. So, let's see. Let's head on into bed first before we start discussing what's going to happen next time. Alright. Whew. Look at all that. Wow, 100 gold just for one coconut? Okay. So, in the next episode, we need to turn in that yam. I'd like to make enough money to buy the best weapon that I currently can, which it costs 25,000. Then, from there, we'll, again, try and head to floor 25, at least. of those mines so we can get that 10,000 gold back, just so we can kind of make our money back for buying the weapon sort of deal. From there, we need to focus on collecting the 9 items for the event, the festival, that is less than a week away. And we also need to make sure that we have money for said festival. So, yeah. I hope you guys have enjoyed, and I guess I will see you next time.